Hi everyone, this is Sean, a trainer at D2L, and today I want to talk about creating a rubric in Brightspace. A rubric is an efficient and effective way to evaluate learners in your course. It provides a consistent experience, and it does save time. From a learner standpoint, a rubric sets expectations in advance, as well as provides detailed feedback so learners know where to go to improve. To find your rubrics, you may look at your nav bar and see a link. And if you don't see it there, try looking under your course admin menu, where you'll see the link to rubrics under the assessments category. When you click on it, it'll take you into the rubrics tool. Now, you can also build rubrics when you're creating activities like assignments and discussions, but here I'm going to create one in advance, so I'll click New Rubric. Rubrics are going to auto-save, so I'm going to start off by giving my rubric a name, and then I'll think about what type of rubric this is. It can be analytic, which is more detailed, or holistic, which looks at the big picture. And I can even change the way that I use a score, whether I use points, custom points that provide a little more flexibility in which points the learner earns, or no score at all. My next step is to begin to fill in the fields that I have here, identifying the criteria that I want to evaluate, and then putting in descriptions of what each level looks like. What does a learner have to do to achieve that level? And if I want to add feedback, I can do that here, building it into the rubric so it will be displayed to the learner once they view that rubric after they've been scored. So I'm going to go ahead and type in a criterion, but I've already got a rubric built that I want to copy and paste out of, so I'm just going to paste the description right into the description field. I keep going until I'm done with all of my different levels and all of my criteria. I can add more criteria at the bottom, or I can use the plus signs to add more levels, or the trash cans to delete levels I don't need. Down at the very bottom, I have an overall score area where I can define the ranges that work for each of the different levels, and I can provide overall descriptions of what each level looks like. Once I'm done with that, I've got the basics of my rubric down, I'm ready to associate it with a learning activity, and then I'm ready to evaluate my learners once they've completed that activity. That's it for me. Go give it a shot, and good luck.